Hey everybody, Crystal Gamer here, back with Katarina Loverly, our once homeless girl who is totally not homeless anymore at all. Look at this place. It's so cute now. I'm so happy with it. And so is she. She's got a cute little front porch area. She's got this little, look at this little swing. I love this. This is a hanging swing thing, which is just fabulous. Love that. Some little greenery out front. She's expanded her gardening area. She's getting more and more into gardening. So she's expanded her garden area. She added some horseshoes out back, and don't tell anyone, but this is actually going off her property. So it's making her property look slightly larger than it is. And she's got some stuff out on the deck now. She's got a brand new grill, place to eat, little seating area with a little overhang and everything now. Some wind chimes, all of that stuff. So that's her outside of her place now. So cute. And it is pretty much taking up, like this house is taking up this little, I think it's a 20 by 20 lot. So she doesn't have much more room to expand outward anymore. And interior wise, I want to say since you guys last saw it, we have a kind of a new bedroom, a lot of new bedroom stuff. She spent $8,000 on a bed that has a rating of 10s across the board, matching triptych and all that. A couple of new decor pieces in here, new mirror, the lamp, a few things changed color. I changed the color of the lamp. I changed the color of the dresser, the stylish woman painting and all of that stuff and added the curtains. So, and of course the overall room color is now the navy blue. So that's a change as well. And her music studio is now a bit larger and has a seating area. And I think those are the main interior changes since you guys last saw it. She's had more exterior changes. So we've had that going on. And then the other stuff that we've had going on in her world of music, she released 5 songs to Dinky Beats since the royalty review that we did a couple of episodes back. The only thing that's really super crappy about this is we can't see any of them or how much money they're making. There's a glitch in the game that doesn't allow us to see beyond very much with our notification wall. Like it won't. It'll allow, I think it's up to 16 songs on the notification wall, and that's it. It doesn't allow anything more than that, and Katarina is up well over 16 songs now. So, yeah, we can no longer see the songs that we're missing are Cosmic Cotton and Vanilla Sunshine. Katarina performs Carol of the Bells, which we had a music video for. Prophecy of the Evil Sloth Nuggets, which I think was a pretty big hit. I mean, it has a fabulous name, right? But no, seriously, I think it was actually a pretty big hit judging by how much her pay jumped. Because she's getting paid, we're just not seeing them. And then we had Lady Vi's song, the one that won the song contest, the I Like It When Your Beep Beep Goes Boop Boop, and it makes my heart go roar. So that was the winning song contest. I think that did pretty well. And then we had Walking on Moonwater. And so all of those were with Dinky Beats. We can't see how much money any of them are making, unfortunately. So I'm a little bit bummed about that because I like numbers. I like to track the stuff and see where it's going and how it's doing. But she's making a ton of money. So we have that. But now what she did, now we had the fire where, you know, Treasure almost died and that was scary. And then she took a couple of days off after the fire to go fishing and be one with nature and do her thing where she unwinds and de-stresses and all of that. And then after her trip, she got back. She had that successful date, finally a successful date. And in all of that distraction between the fire and the time off and the date, all of that stuff, she kind of forgot to release any tracks. And so Dinky Beats canned her. They let her go. They said, sorry, you're not releasing enough tracks. We demand more. And so they let her go. So in need of a new label, she recorded a song that she thought was outstanding, and she put it out there in hopes that it would be noticed by the label, by a label, another label. And it was called Moo Beast Tippin' in the Rain, by the way. Well, apparently it was good enough that the new tastemakers called her very quickly. So she was very happy about that since they're an even better label than Dinky Beats anyway. So that means she should be able to make even more money with them. So she signed with them right away and has already had her first track, Eternal Boom Puffs on Parade, released by them. And her next track, Ganja Monkeys, is actually, I think that is also, that's been released now to the new Tastemakers as well. There was a little bit of a panic about royalties for a minute because when Dinky Beats canceled her, I wasn't sure if she was still going to get her all her royalties or lose her royalties from them dropping her. So if you ever have this happen to a sim, they don't lose the royalties. She's still getting money off of all those songs. So that is good to know, I'm thinking. Now, it's especially good to know since Katarina lost her new label to, I don't know what she was doing. She was, I don't know, hanging out with Danny, doing other things, whatever. But something happened. She missed the notices. She didn't see the notices that she needed to release another track. And so she lost the new label as well after only a couple of tracks were released. So now she has released a new track to the Symphy service called Trollops Traipsing Through the Tulips. And she's hoping that someone else will pick her up, that she'll have another label come pick her up. In the meantime, she has also licensed a violin song and become a B-list celebrity. So on the B-lister, it says, Katarina's celebrity presence is really taking shape. She can now confidently call herself a B-lister. Woohoo! As a 3-star celebrity, she can now give hugs to or take selfies with her fans. Unfortunately, the paparazzi have also started to take interest in her day-to-day life. Watch out for them when she's out in public. So that part is not going to be very good for Katarina. She's not a real big fan of the fame part of the equation. I mean, she's kind of always wanted to be a famous musician, but sort of without the fame. You know what I mean? Like with the lucrative stuff and the name recognition, but without, like, she doesn't really want to be recognized everywhere and bothered by paparazzi. And she's not much for mingling with stars. I mean, she's a good old country girl. She's good old hometown country girl, you know? So this part might be a little bit difficult for her, that she's going to have the paparazzi all over the place. But it says, thankfully, there's a way to retain some semblance of privacy when hitting the town. Katarina can use the mirror to apply a celebrity disguise, which will allow her to freely walk amongst the general public. Now, Katarina has not tried that yet. So that should be pretty interesting. I'm dying to see what the celebrity disguise is. So she's a full-blown 3-star B-lister. She's got a good reputation. And I think that this is in part because she has so much money now that she keeps donating money to charity and all of this stuff. And she did a volunteer food drive thing, like give food for the homeless thing. And so she's done a few kind of good deeds. And I think that that is why she's developing this good reputation as a nice little angelic star here. Although I had a friend of mine tell me that good reputations are boring. So I don't know, but I don't know. We like Katarina being nice and goodly and all of that stuff. It's nice having a good person with a good reputation. And I almost forgot, we want to go, where is the thing? We want to go here. That's what I wanted to. I wanted to look at this for a second because, and show you the stuff that I selected for her or that she selected. So I had her going down this road before, but the problem that I'm finding with this road, with the way the game handles it, is that it doesn't like musicians. Like, it's designed for someone who's doing the video thing, that video station and walking around with drones and all of that stuff. And that is definitely not Katarina's thing. She is not going to do all that kind of fame and all of that stuff. Definitely not. Her thing is all about the music. So by going this route, she keeps getting offered gigs over and over, but there are gigs that have to do with the video station and, you know, doing stuff with the drone and all of that. So because that's not really working, we started looking at this other direction here, and she's not much for stars. So this is the other thing, like getting along with stars and all this. And she finds a lot of the stars to be kind of snooty, snobby. She does not want to become one of them. So she's kind of adverse a little bit to this right now. That may change, but right now she's not loving this. So this section here, this Celebu serum, apparently she gets potions in the mail and It's an exclusive service for the elite in society. And so now she'll get these potions, and it says that it can boost her needs or adjust her emotions. But either way, it's guaranteed to increase the rate at which she increases her skills for a period of time. So that part's pretty cool. And as a matter of fact, she just got the mail, and in the mail she got... Where is it? It's this right here. So she got her first confident Celebu serum. So her first Celebu serum is a confident one. It says that she can boost skill games, side effects, instills a sense of confidence. So that seems pretty good, especially since right now she's still practicing the piano. She's trying to get to the point where she can license songs on the piano as well. So that's something that could help with that. So that's sort of an interesting thing on the stars that she gets that as a little bit of a benefit. But the main reason that we went this route here is because of this here, the next one up, when she gets another point. So this established name thing says that she can get more money when she sells, publishes, or licenses something that took skill to create. She'll earn more money and increased royalties. So that is the main reason we're going in this direction. Now, unfortunately, or fortunately, depending how you want to look at it, I ended up choosing this instead of going here. So we have to wait a little while till she gets another point to end up choosing this. But this one here is a giving back one, and It's she gets this because of good reputation. I guess you get offered these with good reputation and these choices with bad reputation. So since she has good reputation, she can now establish her foothold in the public eye as a charitable and kindly celebrity, which I think she's already done that a little bit. And so now she'll gain reputation even faster. And she can now donate objects from her home to legions of fans. Now, the unfortunate thing that I've seen since we've selected this is that it's all stuff that she does stuff with, like her keyboard she could donate, or she can donate the dog bowl or whatnot. So she can donate different things, but they seem to be things that she would probably have to replace. So I'm not sure how much she's going to do that. She's got plenty of money now, though, so she may do some of that. So we'll see. But that is her fame status now. So she's kind of gained a little bit. Like I said, licensed a violin song. She licensed a Rise Chicken a second time. And so that's not making as much money as it did. But she didn't have another song, a violin song, yet to license, because she's been super focused on the piano and trying to get that up to a point where she can license songs on that. And as you can see, I should leave this up for a second. As you can see by this royalty report, we lose everything after Oh Solo Yuo. We can't see anything beyond that. So we're still seeing our old stuff that's like making her not very much money, and we're not seeing the stuff that's making her a lot of money. And I know that she's making a lot of money because this is not showing, I think it's 3,600 and change was what she made last time. This most recent time, that's what she got in with this royalty report. So this is definitely not $3,600 and change. So we're missing a lot. We're not seeing a lot of what's happening here. So fingers crossed that they get that fixed soon. In other somewhat surprisingly lucrative endeavors, Katarina is doing gardening because she enjoys it and she loves being outside. She's an outdoors girl. But these things, she's got these things going. Her strawberries are making her 78 bucks a pop. These here, the snapdragons, 115 bucks a pop. And the mushrooms, not very lucrative, only $6 a pop. But she's able to harvest these three things like almost daily now. And we're to the point that I can't even remember what the rest of this stuff is, because it hasn't started blooming yet. I think we have some dragon fruit or something, and maybe it's out of season. So she's got it planted, but she's making all kinds of money off of these three, like almost every day, every other day. So that's pretty freaking cool, I think. But I know, all right, I know that you all are saying, all right, Crystal, enough with her rags to riches status. What about the date? Did she have a second date? I know y'all are wondering. But see, what I'm doing here is I'm creating an air of mystery and suspense. I don't know about all that. I'm doing something. Maybe I'm just being evil, like making y'all wait. But Anyway, yes, she had a second date, so I'll eliminate that suspense. She had a second date with Kiana, but before we get into the date, we're going to get real for a second and look at Katarina's position for a moment and what has happened in a very short time. So, first off, we know that Katarina has been intrigued by the idea of being with a woman, but she's never been with a woman. In all reality, she doesn't have very much experience. I mean, her parents died when she was a senior in high school, right after she turned 18. She was still in freaking high school. She was with that guy, Jason, and she was with him for several years, and he had massive control over her to the point that she had no social life outside of him. And she only dated a couple of people before him. So Katarina is not exceptionally experienced in relationships or sex or any of that stuff. She'd like to be. She had all kinds of designs about, like, if you remember last New Year's, not the most recent New Year's that just passed, but the one before that, if you remember, she was still busking at the club and she had a good time that night. She was like, oh man, this clubbing stuff's fantastic. I want to go clubbing. I want to go dating. I want to do all of this stuff. And so she was thinking all that. And yes, she had the dream about being a famous musician, but you know, when you're sleeping on park benches and you're busking places just for a few dollars to get by, the dream of being a famous star with a lot of money is that's feeling pretty far off. But she has very recently kind of skyrocketed to fame. So the whole idea of going clubbing all the time and dating a lot and all of that stuff, like, things are changing. She has paparazzi outside of her house now, hanging out, being annoying. She can't go anywhere without being recognized. People are fainting at her feet. It's kind of insane now. So she's intrigued about the idea of being with a woman, but now anything she does, whether it's with a woman, whether it's a man, any dating, anything she does is now like potential public fodder. So, you know, if you're going to do some sexual experimentation and everything, it's hard enough to do that, let alone do it in the public eye. So the first time Kiana called her, she was conveniently busy because she's kind of not sure about this. She's sort of interested, but she's not sure. Second time Kiana called her, she called her and asked her if she wanted to go to the Rojo. Now, the Rojo is one of Katarina's favorite places to go. They have an open mic thing. She just really likes the place. So she said yes, in part because she likes the place and she gets a lot of good attention there. You know, she has participated in the open mic stuff there before and it's good. So she said yes, but for some reason, instead of the Rojo, they ended up at this place, which I'm not even 100% sure exactly where this place is. I think it's a bar in Salvadorada. So I don't know exactly why they ended up here, but they did. And Katarina figured, well, all right, she'll just go with it. And it started out pretty good. You know, they had a kiss hello, which was a nice thing. They seemed to get along pretty well right away. Unfortunately, this was accompanied by a fan fainting at Katarina's feet again. So that was a little bit awkward. And then, you know, they tried to hang out front and talk for a little bit. But again, with Katarina's fans sort of hanging about and just a lot of extra unwanted attention, let's call it that. So they were trying to talk, but yeah, there were definitely other people around, and then they ended up with paparazzi and everything. And, you know, Katarina doesn't want to be rude. She wants to be good to her fans. She wouldn't be where she was if it weren't for her fans, if they weren't buying her music. And, you know, so she wants to play up for the camera a little bit. She does a little bit of posing and all of that stuff. So, you know, Kiana's just kind of hanging out while Katarina's getting all this attention. So that's happening. Then they go in the bar. Katarina buys a round of drinks So, you know, she does that inside, but then the tables in this place is not really designed for one-on-one. There's kind of tables in groups, and so they end up joined again by more people. They're surrounded by people the whole time. And then, go figure what always happens to Katarina. Things got awkward. Don't know why, don't know how, but they ended up getting awkward, and it was not good. And at the end of it, Kiana ended up saying to her, well, yeah, that was fine, and maybe I'll call you, maybe. And so, yet another busted date. Katarina is not having any luck in this realm. And now, being as famous as she is, she does not know what to do now. Like, she doesn't even know how she's going to date. She doesn't know how this is going to work at all. She's a little bit of a loner to begin with, because she's having a little bit of a hard time, you know, interacting socially and everything. And so all these designs that she had about dating and everything, she's having a very hard time making them happen. And now she's having an even harder time because of the fame. So it's kind of interesting. There are definitely perks to being this famous. And on the other hand, there's definitely some drawbacks to that. But we needn't despair, because Katarina is nothing if not resilient. So after that date, she decides to do some self-improvement and take up yoga. And since she has a bar in the house, she figures that she should learn how to make some drinks. So she's keeping herself plenty occupied, and we don't need to worry about her. Plus, next week, she meets someone new. So we'll see what happens then. But in the interest of time, we do have to leave Katarina for today. So thanks so much for watching. If you enjoyed this episode, please don't forget to hit that like button before you leave. And if you're not yet subscribed to the channel, it'd be awesome to have you hit that little subscribe button and join me here for all kinds of Sims content. Don't forget to hit the little bell for notifications too. And please do comment and let me know what you thought of the episode below. And thanks again for spending the time with me today, and I hope to see y'all back again next time. Bye now.